Hey everyone, Jason Ballas, OutdoorProductReview.com. Today I want to cover the VAP arrow, the Victory Armor Piercing Arrow. All right, yesterday I was setting up my bow, and I got all my hunting arrows ready, and they're all fletched up. And matter of fact, I used the same vanes that were sent to me from the guys over there at the Goat Tough folks. And we set it up. This is the VAP. Now it's 408 grains, just like our arrow that we're using in the review this year. So if you see, this one's different. It has the white vane with the yellow vanes on there as well. Now, I'm going to show you last year's arrow from our review, 373 grains. Now, this is the V-Force from Victory Archery, and this right here is the VAP. Big difference in diameter. I showed you guys that. The thing that's going to be different is the surface area that's going to be on this VAP. Now, I want to show you guys something. I was setting up my bow, shot the first shot, and I noticed a bunch of dust come off the target, and I was trying to figure out what was going on. So I pulled the arrow out, shot another shot. Same thing happened, except for this time I pulled my arrow out, and the outsert on the VAP arrow was actually bent. And I looked, and there was a bunch of dust on the front. And I looked behind the target, and it so happened that it went completely through the target and struck the center block. So, that being said, I went ahead and I got another arrow ready, and I went and I shot it again, but this time with the target away, and it went completely up to the fletching and still hit the center block. Now, this is a brand new cube target I've had, probably only 100 arrows in it. And you guys have probably seen this target last year on the review. I got it last year for the review, and I only shot about 100 arrows into it. So, with that being said, I was pretty impressed. So I want to show you guys something here. Now, I'm shooting these out of a Black Mamba MX2 set at 70 pounds, 29 inches. The arrows are 28 and 3/4 inch long. Now, if you're going to see, the first shot that I'm going to do is going to be the V-Force. You're going to watch it right here. It's going to hit, and you're going to see, yes, it goes into the target, but the penetration is nothing compared to what you're going to see right here. This is the VAP being shot, see? It goes completely through the target. Matter of fact, it went all the way up to the nock. So if you had a doubt with any kind of penetration, that VAP arrow, if you guys haven't tried one of these, you need to go down to one of your local dealers and shoot it. Might seem a little bit heavier, but I'm telling you what, the penetration that you're going to get with this VAP is definitely something that I'm going to like to see out there with everybody hunting, because I'd love to see some of the pictures of guys, you know, shooting stuff, because you're going to get complete penetration. I don't think you're going to have a problem with the full pass-through on any big game animal as long as you hit them in the right spot. If you hit a, you know, shoulder joint or something on a moose or something, you might not go all the way through. However, you are going to have a lot more penetration than you would with just a normal shaft like this V-Force sitting right here. So, tell you what, you guys need to visit victoryarchery.com or go see one of your local dealers for them and check out the new VAP arrow from Victory Archery. So I hope you guys enjoyed that little segment. And if you guys are still undecided, you know what? Give me a call. I'll shoot it through a cinder block. I'll shoot it through anything. Just send me an email off the site here, and I'll show you the difference between both of these shafts, because you know what? I would test it for you so that you don't have to waste the money to test it yourself. So for Outdoor Product Review, I'm Jason Ballas. You guys come on back and see us on any of our reviews that we have, because we have some great stuff coming up this fall.